thank you so much for taking the time to hear the powerful word of truth from Prophet Bishop H. Walker. By way of special announcements, join Prophet Walker at True Life Pentecost Church every second Sunday of each month in Atlanta, Georgia at 957 Metropolitan Parkway at 4:30 p.m. Also join in with True Light every fourth Sunday of each month in Charlotte, North Carolina at 300 North Tryon Street, located at the Public Library of Charlotte. For further details, go to www.truelightpentecost.org and click on announcements for any current events. Thank you so much for supporting Prophet Walker and the True Light Ministry. Be encouraged and be blessed. You are now viewing Prophet H. Walker and True Light Pentecost Church. Those that are viewing and seeking after righteousness, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Lord help me. He kept me walking. He got loud. This happened to say, wait a minute, why don't you be quiet? You're making too much noise. Don't you know who that is? You're making too much noise. And the Bible says he got loud. Yeah. He said, oh, Lord, son of David.
Hey!
separated. Amen.
Please, Rob.
I don't care how you fix AIDS. All right. It's still AIDS.
Amen.
Love lift me up. Amen. If God don't work the miracle in your life, you'll never be able to stand.
Amen.
But God gets attention from the seekers of truth.
Yes.
Now I want y'all to hear me close this morning. It ain't gonna be wrong.
Amen.
Through a praise and worship. This is why when we come to church, we praise and worship God. We allow for the Spirit to have its way. Then we get into the message or the teaching. But you first got to let God be God.
Amen.
In your life. It's so important that we not bring any inhibitions into church, any negative context, any negative
Amen.
Spirit,
Amen.
Amen, into the house of faith. We're trying to worship God and reach up.
Amen.
Amen. I said, the woman, she just wanted to get close enough to touch the hem of his garment. His, I want to just touch his coat. The bottom part. Him is the bottom part.
Amen.
Amen. So she had to be on her knees.
Amen.
Submission. Hallelujah. It's so important to understand that God knew the woman was coming through the crowd. Now, this woman had been sick for a period of years. Weak. Dying. Went to the doctors and they couldn't help her. But you heard about Jesus. Now, when she was coming to Jesus before the crowd had left him,
all right,
praise God.
Amen.
She had to press her way through the crowd. In other words, she had to push people.
That's
now
right.
She's sick now. Uh-huh. You know she wanted to close enough to him for a reason.
Amen.
She took all her strength, all her power and her might to get close to him. And I imagine on that way, she was saying, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, I worship you. Lord, I praise you.
Amen.
God allowed for a little break in the crowd so she could ease through and then touch it and get her blessing. I want to deal with the sermon tonight. Y'all pray me a little while. Matthew's Gospel chapter, I believe that's chapter 15. And the text I'm trying to show you, if you let the Lord have his way. In order to receive your divine intervention, you got to be in the right place at the right time. Sometimes we go to church, we don't necessarily feel like going to church, and some sit back and will not get into the service. And praise God, if that's, amen, if that's, that's the way you want to worship God. That's between you and God.
Amen.
I'm worshiping.
Amen.
Praise
you. Amen.
I might have to pray for somebody else, but praise God, I'm going to worship and praise
you. Amen.
I'm going to let God know. I know he's God.
Amen.
And I know he can bring me out of every situation and every condition.
Amen.
But you can't get God's attention unless you worship and praise him.
Amen.
When the Barnabas and Paul was in that inner prison, they knew they were in a condition they could not help themselves.
Amen.
So what did they do? They said, let's get God's attention.
Right, right.
Let's start praising him.
Amen.
They started having church.
Amen.
And praising him. And that's when God intervened on their behalf and sent an earthquake. Brother says, I'm telling you, there's nothing that you're going through right now that God can't divinely intervene and deliver you and bring you out with a total victory. Upset. He called me twice yesterday. Why are you worried me? Why are you worried about it?
Amen.
I thought you knew left and God. Why don't you leave us alone?
Amen.
Yeah, I'm happy.
Yeah.
Invisible.
Yeah.
Oh, praise God. Not one, but call me twice.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
What you need to do is try to get close to God.
Yeah.
Try to figure out a way how you can come back into true holiness.
Yeah.
And if you're so blasphemy, that's what you ought to do. Greater things come against you.
Amen. Yes.
Foolish people, you don't need the church of God. And when you get put out, you got to try to find a way to get back in God's presence. angels. And the night coming,
right.
No man can.
No man.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Here in this text, brothers and sisters, we see, I want to pick up in verse 22.
And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with the devil.
Uh-huh.
But he answered her not a word.
Now, vexed with the devil can mean the devil has attacked her flesh, she's dying, or she has epilepsy or one of those type of demon spirits. She needed divine intervention. Now, to show you the importance of praise and worship, she was a Gentile, Canaanite Gentile, a non-believer. She was not a Jew.
Amen.
There was a time when Jesus, in his earthly ministry, he only ministered to Jews. The Gentile really didn't come in until after the death, burial, and resurrection, when the covenant promise was open to all the New Testament church. Or whosoever will, let him come and drink freely at the fountain. But there was a time when God ministered only to the Jews. Won't you watch those? Now read.
But he answered her not a word. And his disciples.
Now she came and asked God for mercy.
Yeah.
But he didn't pay any attention to her. Why?
Nope.
And his disciples came and besought him, saying, send her away, for she crieth after us.
But now the disciples knew the covenant, old covenant, to the Hebrew people. No, she was a Canaanite. So they tried to send her away. She wouldn't leave, obviously. So they told God, said, why don't you just go and send her away?
Right.
Read.
But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep.
Now he was telling the disciples and her, I'm not sent to the Gentiles yet. I'm only come to the Jews, to the Hebrew people, the chosen, the seed of Abraham. Read.
Then came she and worshipped him, saying, what? Lord, worship him.
Amen.
All right. If you listen to what I'm saying.
Right. Yes.
She knew that she was a Canaanite, and she also knew the Hebrew covenant.
Right.
But nevertheless, she knew there was something about this prophet that had divine power.
Amen.
She didn't know he was God in the flesh, but she knew that he had done some miracles.
Right.
And she needed a miracle. She needed divine intervention.
Right.
And she knew also, I can't come to know tabernacle, or I can't come to know church where he's at, because I'm an outsider.
Right.
I'm a Canaanite. But I still need this divine intervention, and you're not going to drive me away. I'm going to pray, and I'm going to worship.
Lord help me. But he answered and said, it is not meet to take the children's bread and cast it to dogs.
Uh-huh.
And she said, truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table.
How do you
do?
Now she's trying to say, I'm a sinner, but I still know you can help me.
Amen.
I'm not a part of the covenant, but I still know you got the power.
Amen.
Watch those.
Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith.
What?
Great is thy faith.
She didn't get discouraged because something came against her. She didn't even get discouraged when God told her, not your time yet. She kept on worshiping him and praising him. I'm trying to let you know, when you make up your mind, you want something from God. Hallelujah. You will not let nothing discourage you. Praise God, if nobody in the church thinks you are better, everybody thinks you are, you still got to keep coming back to the church and praising God and worshiping God and lifting up the name of God. Find out what you want. Not your brother and your sister. God is the one who died for you. Not your brother and your sister. Not your mother. Not your daddy. Not your granddaddy. How do your first cousin, second cousin, third cousin, twice removed? Ain't nobody died for you but God himself. You wouldn't go let nobody discourage you. Bible says you came and worshiped him anyway. And finally God turned around and said, woman, great is thy faith.
Read. O woman, great is thy faith, be it unto thee even as thou wilt.
Yes. In other words, you want something? It's already settled.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Right.
Hallelujah. Yes. And again, when she got back home, her daughter was healed.
Amen.
Oh, praise God. But what if she got discouraged? What if she had not kept coming to church? Why she quit the church and turned around and said, this ain't working. It's not working out right. Hallelujah. And get all discouraged and tied up with the four elements. Praise God, she was alone.
Yeah.
time you come to God, you better learn how to come to God by yourself.
All right, Papa.
Devil don't want you in church.
Amen.
Wrong spirits don't want you in church.
All right.
They have to scare you every way they can. Plans of men don't mean 2 cents.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Right. Your relationship is with the church of God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I got to do it this way.
Yeah.
Because that's the way they say it. But we are separated people.
Amen.
We're not like that. I got to go over here with God here.
Amen.
And I'm going to keep following him and keep praising him and keep worshiping until finally God turn around and see about me. Oh, praise God. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Blind man was crying by the side of the road.
Come on.
Jesus walked by.
Amen.
He said, oh, Lord, help me. He kept on walking. He got loud. Disciples said, wait a minute, why don't you be quiet? You're making too much noise.
Amen.
Don't you know who that is? You're making too much noise. And the Bible said he got loud.
Yeah.
He said, oh Lord, Son of David. That was in the Old Testament church. They said that Son of David came from the seed of David. Or from, it was the Messiah.
Yeah.
The Christ.
Yeah.
When he said Son of David, God stopped.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
He said, bring him here.
All right.
Amen.
Amen. It's not one that said, be of good cheer.
Amen.
Call it. It's all right now. Everything is done now. Oh, praise God. What is that you want? You already knew what you want.
Amen.
But you had to hear it. Sometimes you got to tell God what you need.
That's right.
No, say, Lord, help me, Lord, help me, Lord, help me. Yeah, but what do you need?
All right,
Pop.
Hallelujah. He wants you to speak it out your mouth. Let me know. I know you can stop it. I know if you want it, you'd already have it. Promise you don't have it. So you want me to give it to you. Hallelujah. What do you need? My eyes. Hallelujah. And God touched me. Praise God. He said, how do you see? He said, I see men like trees.
Like
I ain't good enough.
Amen.
Back here.
All right. Look.
I got to touch you again.
All
I got to pray for you again. Touch again. He said, now how do you see? I see men like me. Sometimes church, you come to church, but you need another church. You better make sure you get the right church. You better make sure you don't need church. But then you get the right spirit in you, the right thing in you. But you can make it through this life together. You cannot make it without the right thing in you. And God alone got the right thing. You want it?
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Yeah.
You got to have a determined mind.
Amen.
And you got to be all alone. Can you hear me? God works on an individual plane. You can reach out to everybody. Say, please, come on. Let's go. Come on. We're going. Let's. No, sometimes you got to make up your mind.
Yeah.
Well, what's the sister doing there? What's the sister? Please, leave me alone. I need something.
Hey,
honestly, you can't get a job.
All right.
You don't have what I need. But I know somebody.
All right.
All that I do is make it that sanctified church. Oh, you go to that sanctified church. Don't nobody go to that church. Oh, yes, they do. I go.
Amen.
Right. Amen.
I go.
All right.
Thank you, Lord.
That king and that woman might ask a whole lot of people.
Amen.
Come and go and say, hey, you know you can't go. Those Jews, you need them to go alone. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But finally she made up her mind.
Mm-hmm.
And she went herself.
Yeah.
Nobody with her.
Yeah.
And then when she found out God was going to pass her by, she began to praise and worship him.
Yeah.
God had to stop him. Every which way, would you have mercy?
Glory.
Hallelujah. to the world and she kept on praising.
Amen.
Finally, he had to stop. Go your way. Your faith has solved this problem. Now here's the point, church. God had to have a testimony. And he knew the condition of this woman and her child.
Amen.
He also knew the political status at the time of the covenant.
Amen.
He was still in the old covenant. New covenant couldn't come until death, burial, and resurrection. He knew this. But he knew this woman was not going to give up.
Amen.
And she praised him and worshiped him until finally God said, now I got a testimony to put in the book so somebody can know. If I keep praising him, if I keep staying in the church, and don't leave the church, don't leave with them, no. I got to be with God here. I'll get the victory.
Amen.
And use that testimony to put in the Bible so that you can get the victory as long as you stay with God.
Thank you.
There's nothing out there in that world.
No.
Amen.
No pleasure.
Amen.
No good times.
Amen.
It's facades.
Yes.
Make you think it's a good time. Make you think this is good. But in your heart, you know.
Amen.
Ain't but one way.
That's right.
Amen. And that's true holiness. Ain't but one God. Ain't but one true God.
Amen.
John, I'm getting ready quick. First chapter. I think I want to jump right into verse 5.
And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not.
Read.
There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light.
Now we are not God, Amen. But we come to bear witness of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Back up to verse 4.
In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe.
Jump to verse 9.
That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world.
The true light that lighteth every man that cometh into the world. You got to come by the true light.
Amen.
God says so.
Right.
I do. God says so.
Right.
Are we the true light?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Hello, hallelujah.
Because of the Spirit.
Right.
He's going to bear witness of the true light, and through the Spirit of God that dwells in us, then we are the true light.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And light prepared to what?
That was the light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world.
Some men.
Every man.
Most men.
Every.
Now that's in the masculine, but it also means woman too. Did y'all know that?
Amen.
Every man and woman have to come through the true light.
Glory, hallelujah.
Why do you say that? Because the Bible says.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right, brother.
Don't argue with me, argue with the Bible.
All right.
That TDJ cross represent.
Amen.
Creflo Dollar.
Yes.
The cross represents. Joel Osteen cross represents.
Yes. Lord, hallelujah.
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 He's a wonderful Savior to me.
He's a wonderful Savior to me.
Some praise reports. Dr. Samaya, $160. Amen. Daughter Taylor, 6 pieces of gold. Amen. And I'm going to give him $300. Amen. Now Chris, $53. Amen. Brother Brown, $44. $400. Also, Dr. Bianca gave an envelope, $100. And Roger gave an envelope the other day, 10 pieces of gold. So, in case I don't call your name now, amen. I got Roger's envelope, but you can't call your name.
Thank you so much for taking the time to hear the powerful word of truth from Prophet Bishop H. Walker. By way of special announcements, join Prophet Walker in True Life Pentecost Church every second Sunday of each month in Atlanta, Georgia at 957 Metropolitan Parkway at 4:30 p.m. Also join in with True Light every fourth Sunday of each month in Charlotte, North Carolina at 300 North Tryon Street, located at the Public Library of Charlotte. For further details, go to www.truelightpentecost.org and click on announcements for any current events. Thank you so much for supporting Prophet Walker in the True Light Ministry. Be encouraged and be blessed.
Blog Talk Radio.